Did you know that your body has receptors for cannabinoids? And that right now, your body is producing your own endogenous cannabinoids that are activating those receptors? So let's talk about cannabis and cannabinoids today. At the end of this video, you may leave your comments, questions, or suggestions for future topics. Remember that this YouTube channel is not to offer individual patients advice. It's rather just a channel to learn more about pain. And if you think that you have a condition that is causing you chronic pain, please consult your physician to get a proper diagnosis and treatment plan for you. Today we are going to talk about cannabinoids. And what are cannabinoids? Let's first take a look at the cannabis plant. The cannabis plant has about 500 substances, and 113 of those substances are cannabinoids. Cannabinoids are chemical substances that are able to activate receptors that we have in our body. The other substances that are not cannabinoids, there are things that give the smell of the plant, like the terpenoids, and other substances that give the shape of the plant. The human body has two types of receptors for cannabinoids. They are called CB1 and CB2. The CB1 receptor is mainly found in the brain and central nerve system. The CB2 receptor is mainly found in the immune system and in the guts. And did you know that our body produces our own cannabinoids that activate those receptors? One example of those is a substance called anandamide. There are also synthetic cannabinoids that are produced in laboratory. Examples of this are the Dronabinol and the Nabilone. Dronabinol is a medication that is approved in Canada, and it used to be marketed, it's not available anymore, but it was approved for severe nausea and vomiting related to chemotherapy and also for anorexia related to AIDS and HIV. Nabilone is another synthetic cannabinoid that is already approved in Canada and it's used by many patients. In fact, we had a period of time that we didn't have Nabilone available in Canada because a lot of people were buying it. Nabilone is approved for chemotherapy induced nausea and vomiting, and also there is some off-label use that people use it for severe neuropathic pain and also anorexia related to HIV and AIDS. So regarding the cannabinoids that come from the plant cannabis, as I mentioned to you, there are more than 100 cannabinoids that come from the plant. But we know a little bit more because they have been studied more and identified. We know a little bit more about a handful of those. But the two that have been studied most are the tetrahydrocannabinol, which is the THC, or the cannabidiol, which is known as CBD. So these two cannabinoids, the THC and the CBD, they are extracted from the plant. And there are plants that produce more CBD and less THC. There's another plant that will produce more THC and less CBD. And there are plants that don't produce, they're cannabis plants, but they don't produce any CBD or THC. And those are the hemp plants. And they're used more for its fibers. And what are the effects of the THC in our body? Mainly the effect of the THC is to cause euphoria and some relaxation. Euphoria is a sense of happiness, a sense of well-being. That's how we define euphoria. The effects of the CBD in our body are quite different because CBD does not quite produce euphoria, so it's more used for medicinal purposes and less for recreational purposes. The cannabinoids from the cannabis plant have been approved as medical marijuana in Canada since 2001. The indications for medical marijuana in Canada include things like spasticity from multiple sclerosis, severe neuropathic pain, and also some types of seizures and chemotherapy-induced nausea and vomiting. So now let's talk about the uses of cannabinoids for chronic pain. What are some of the benefits of using cannabinoids for chronic pain? There is some evidence from scientific studies that THC has some benefits for severe types of neuropathic pain. Neuropathic pain is a specific type of chronic pain that is caused by a lesion in the central or peripheral nerve system. Examples of neuropathic pain are things like post-herpetic neuralgia caused by herpes zoster, or painful diabetic neuropathy, which is a kind of pain caused by diabetes. Also pain due to multiple sclerosis, spinal cord injury, or after stroke. There are some reports from patients and case reports published in the literature that CBD also has some effects for chronic pain, especially chronic neuropathic pain. And in fact, some patients may even be able to stop taking opioids because they were taking some CBD. Also, it's a safer option than THC because CBD does not cause any euphoria or impairment of the cognitive thinking. Therefore, the person can drive a vehicle or work in a safe, sensitive position. There is another benefit for using cannabis for chronic pain instead of using opioids for chronic pain, because cannabis, it doesn't cause overdose. There has been no reports of people who overdose because of an intoxication of cannabis or cannabinoids. However, there has been many deaths related to opioids. So it's a safer option if a person has to choose one or the other. And because anxiety, stress, and sleep problems are so common among people who have chronic pain, there has also been some people who used THC and CBD substances because they say that it helps them to manage their anxiety and also to manage their sleep. In terms of the benefits of using smoked, vaporized, or ingesting oils that contain extracts from the plant, I prefer to tell my patients to use oils that they ingest. These oils are produced by a licensed producer. They extract the THC and CBD from the plant and they put in an oil, and the person will ingest this once a day, twice or three times a day. So now let's talk about the risks of using cannabis and cannabinoids for chronic pain. Because the THC has some euphoric effects, like causing that sense of happiness and well-being, there are some people that will become dependent and addicted to the THC, therefore the cannabis plant. And addiction is a problem, a serious problem, which means that the person would like to stop, but they can't quit. It's very hard to quit. Also, the THC has other effects on our thinking. It affects the concentration, coordination, balance, memory, and judgment. So the person who is using THC, we have to advise them not to drive a car and not to be working in safe, sensitive positions like works at heights or things that can be dangerous to themselves or to the others working with them at the workplace. A person who is using inhaled forms of cannabis products, like a vaporizing or smoking, they should wait at least 6 hours before they drive or they go back to work in a safe, sensitive position if they have that kind of work. And if they eat the oils, like the oils that contain THC, they should wait at least 12 hours before they drive or they go back to work, because it takes longer for the substance to be cleared from the digestive system and from the body, so it's not causing any psychotropic effects or that euphoria that can cause problems with concentration, balance, memory, coordination, and judgment. Smoking cannabis has the same risks as smoking tobacco. Vaporizing cannabis has less risks than smoking, but the person will also be inhaling a lot of those cannabinoids that we actually don't know what they do to the body. Women who are pregnant or breastfeeding should not be using cannabinoids. And for people with chronic pain, they should remember that cannabis and cannabinoids are not the first option to treat chronic pain, physical or emotional pain. There are other options that we should put in our toolbox to treat chronic pain that are safer and more effective. Now, if you like this video, please click on the button below. And if you have a question about this video, please write down in the comment box below. I will prepare a future video to answer the questions that you have. If you have a suggestion for a future video, please just write it down. Don't forget to subscribe to this YouTube channel and turn on the notifications so you can be alerted when I post new videos on this website. I also tweet. I have a Facebook page and an Instagram account. Free to go and visit them and leave your comments there too. Bye for now.